Hi, can I get you a room tonight, sir?
Yeah, just a single room, please.
Can I just get your name for that?
It's John. John Taylor.
Quite an interesting little shop you've got here.
Yep, the Last Resort Motel. It's been around longer than I have. That kid in the picture there is actually me. It was about 9 at the time.
You used to come here as a kid?
Well, when I was way younger, me and my family moved here. Well, just the town over, actually. I've known the owner since I've been around here.
No offense, but this place has seen better days.
It used to look just like this. It was actually my father that brought it up to what it was. There was this lake in the back of the resort, and it was beautiful, and it was always packed during the summer.
So why did they let it go to such shit?
The owner died 4 years ago.
So who runs it now?
His wife, but she doesn't come around very much, you know. It's just hard for her. Just reminds her of her husband.
Quite honest, I don't know how much longer this place is gonna last. Aren't you worried about losing your job?
Technically, I'm already out of a job. The lady who owns this place already sold it off to new owners.
What do they plan on doing with it?
They've actually already begun setting up demolition so they can turn it into a new truck depot.
Just like that. All those memories gone.
I don't make the call. You know, I just make sure this place is running. But, you know, I understand. She wants to get this place off her hands. It's a lot. I think she deserves a fresh start.
You ever plan on leaving this town?
I mean, that's the goal. Isn't it for everyone? You know, I really want to travel. Nowhere specific, but, you know, just anywhere but here.
What about your dad? Did he ever come visit you?
No. Not as often as he used to. He's away right now.
Nice. I should call it a night.
Yeah, okay. So your room number is 2. Here you go. So when you go outside, it'll just be 2 doors on your left. One last thing. What brings you out here?
Business.
Good night. Last Resort Motel, how can I help you?
Hi, sir. We were just calling in to inform there's been a robbery near your area at a local jewelry store. The fugitive was said to have run away and was last seen in the surrounding vicinity.
Is there any way I can identify him?
Tall man seen wearing a coat, mid-30s.
Did he have a red suitcase with him?
Yes. Would it be informed? He was carrying some form of luggage.
Wait. Yeah, okay. I think I've seen him. He came in here looking for a room earlier. Can you send somebody over? He's in one of the suites right now.
We'll be sending someone shortly.
Good evening, everyone. This is Jill Redden with Local 10 News. We opened tonight with a surreal robbery, leaving the community stunned. Locally owned and family-run McKinnon's Jewelry Store was robbed earlier this evening. The suspect ran into the store at gunpoint and had already fled by the time authorities arrived on the scene.
Thank you. Drop the bag.
What is this? You're the one that did this. You're the one that they're out there looking for.
It's not like that. I had no choice.
I'm sure you had plenty of choices.
What was your plan? You're just gonna sit here and hide it out till the whole thing blew over?
I didn't hurt anyone, all right? A man blackmailed me. I would never go back to crime if I had a choice. Ever.
Now, what does this man have on you?
He's from Child Services. Lost custody of my daughter the first time I got caught. Her mother passed away and she's been in foster care ever since. He cut me a deal. He said he could pull some strings if I just helped him with this one job. He said he could get my daughter back.
It's a pretty crazy story to believe.
I know it's hard to believe, man, but please, I need your help. I just want to see her. What would you do if it was your family?
My father is not away. Truth is, I know exactly where he is. A while ago, I had an older sister. And one night, she was out with her friends and they got hit by a drunk driver. My father was so mad. He tracked the man down and he's...
God.
He killed him. And he knew right then that we had to leave. We had to start a new life, so we packed up our stuff. Father, me and my mom. In time he got caught. He was sentenced to 25 years. Only my mother knew. Then, you know, the court hearing made it public. My point is, if anybody knows what kind of crazy things someone's willing to do for their family, it's me. Stay here. I'm gonna check it out.
Sorry for the wait, sir. How can I help you tonight?
Oh, I'm not here to stay the night. In fact, I'm Detective Colwell. I'm here investigating a fugitive that's said to be sheltering here tonight.
Yeah, I think I saw something like that on the news, but... pretty sure it's just a hoax. We haven't taken anybody in here this evening.
Really? That's strange. Must be missing a pair of keys then.
Yeah, lost it. You know, it's an old place. We lose things. All the time.
Well. Sorry for the inconvenience. You be careful, though. The fugitive is a dangerous man. No telling what he's capable of.
Of course.
Hello, John. Your heart fell into fine. Look, I got what you wanted. I know she's with you. I just want to see her.
You're right.
She is with me. Now hand over the bag. You don't have to do this. Nobody saw me.
Oh, John, you poor soul. You're all over the news.
You left blood behind for forensics to find.
I won't have to be smart, John. But I told you what would happen if anything went wrong.
So, you pretend to be this detective? Convince everybody that you're the good guy? You're a real rat, you know that, Adrien? I'm sorry, John. But the truth is, I'm never going to give you a daughter. You're just not fit. She's going to be with family to take care of her. I've changed!
Once a monster, always a monster.
One moment. Hello?
Hi, Detective Cobalt. Or better yet, Adrien.
Who's this?
I work the front desk.
The Bellhopper? How do you know my name?
I've got Veronica here with me. And she tells me all about how you take care of her at the foster home.
I don't think she should be getting involved. I could have you arrested just for keeping her hostage.
See, I don't think that's gonna happen. It just so happens that there is about 2 tons of demolition explosives under the motel ready to blow up.
You really expect me to believe that shit?
No. A little while ago, there was
a demolition crew here setting up explosives, but they had to postpone it.
Fortunately for them, though, I was able to cut a deal. I let them keep their explosives set underground to save them time on the setup again. In exchange, we get to keep the motel running until the demolition date.
What exactly are you saying?
Basically, I'm saying we've been sitting on a gigantic bomb this whole time, and I know where the button is to blow it all up.
You're crazy. You're not gonna blow yourself up for this, man.
And you truly believe I wouldn't?
Then take the bag and leave.
I'm not leaving without the girl!
We've got a suspect down. He's armed and holding a bag.
Veronica?
I missed you so much.
Okay, you guys need to leave now before they find you.
Thank you.
Don't shoot!
Identify yourself.
I just work here. I work at the front desk.
So you're the one who made the call?
Yes. That was me. Thanks again. He was threatening to shoot me in there.
The suspect is dead.
Alright, man. This is your last chance to get anything out that you may have forgotten.
Thank you. Tanuba, get out!